things that we see now are the things are made because God, who is in the spirit realm, created the natural realm. Amen? We know that God is a spirit. That's why, sabi ni Monica kanina, sa Hebrews, ano ang sulat doon? Hallelujah. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Because faith is the engine that drives every hope, every belief into reality. And because of the faith of God, hallelujah, all things will be created. And something as a faith is, faith is a substance of things hoped for and an evidence of things unseen. Hallelujah. Now, things that we see now, the trees, the rivers, the mountains, these are the things that God has made. But the thing that when God made them, He made them from nothing. All He has is His faith to His word. All He has is a faith God's faith that the moment that He speaks His word, something is going to happen. Hallelujah. The title of the message today is The Power of the Word Spoken by Faith. And we see the power of God, we see the power of God, we see the manifestation of the power of God when He has spoken, let there be light, and there was light. Let there be mountains, let the sky separate the water from the deep. Hallelujah. And let there be light. And let there be trees. And let there be herbs. Hallelujah. Everything that has been created were made from the things that are not seen. At ito po ang gusto ipabot sa atin ng Panginoon, na lahat ng mga salita. Now, you know, man has inherited that creative ability. And even the secular world knows about this. Can I give you an example? You know, big companies, big corporations, big businesses are formed because they have found the key that speaking the word, that saying the word is going to create something out of nothing. Let me give you an example. I have 10 examples here. Maybe you will recall these words in our daily lives. Just do it.
Thank you.
Nike. You see, we can easily identify with a brand because that particular word has been made so powerful. The person who has found out the concept was able to see that the words is going to be powerful and it's going to create something out of nothing. Nike. Big business. Think different. Apple. I'm loving it.
McDonald's.
Ito lang ito ng mga babae. Because you're worth it. L'Oreal. You see, the words are very powerful. The words are very powerful. And the moment that they have, that someone is going to speak it out, is going to create something out of nothing. Hallelujah. The ultimate driving machine.
BMW.
BMW. The happiest place on earth.
Disney.
Shopping mall.
Disney. Connecting people. You can basically identify the words to that brand, and when people remember this, hallelujah, remember it will create how the impact it will create in their lives. Make believe.
Sony.
Eat fresh.
Subway.
What about every member a miracle?
Arch.
Hallelujah. You see, those are the things. Make it happen out of nothing. Out of nothing. Just words that are spoken by faith. Hallelujah. That is spoken with something in mind. Hallelujah. With something hoping that it's going to create an impact in your life. Now, the reason why I'm telling you this about, because there is a power in the word spoken by faith. And I want you to start living it. And I want you to start to be, and I want it to be your, and I want it to be your way of life. To have that word spoken and spoken it with authority and with faith. Because when you start doing that, hallelujah, God is going to work on that word that is spoken by faith. Now, there are five things that I want to talk to you about. The first one is, the word is powerful when it is spoken by God to you. The word is going to be powerful when it is spoken by God to you. So this is the word of promises. Okay? Sabi niyo sa inyong katabi, I have a word of promise from God. And sabi sa Isaiah 55:11, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things to where I sent it. Hallelujah. It will not return unto God void. You know, you have this situation that you know that it is God is speaking to you about that word, and you start believing that that word is going to be a rhema in your life. Now, I have this situation early in my Christian life. And that word has become very, 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 very alive and living to me. Hallelujah. And sabi ng Panginoon, every blessed are they, or I will bless them who will bless you, and curse them who will curse you. And from the beginning of my career life, I have noticed it. That every people, every superior that I have who started blessing me, hallelujah, got promoted. Yung CEO ngayon ng Fonterra, ngayon pangalan ay si Theo Spirits. When I worked with him in Saudi Arabia as a as a maintenance engineer, he has promoted me. I was a maintenance planner, and then he was promoted me to a maintenance engineer position. And then his career flourished until such time that right now, hallelujah, he's now the CEO of Auckland, the biggest company in one of the biggest dairy company on all over the world. And then I have another boss, which has promoted me from maintenance engineer to a logistics manager position. Right now he's the manpick. Now right now he is the operations director of the company that I work for in Saudi Arabia, now in Thailand. And slowly, and from then on, I realized that this word that God has spoken to me has been a rhema in my life. And you know, there are 3,573 promises in the Bible. And I believe out of those 3,573, some of them has the promises made by God to you. And when you hear that word, hallelujah, ang sabi ng Panginoon, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. What I promise you, I am going to do. What I promise you, saith the Lord, it's going to accomplish my purpose in your life. Hallelujah. It has among promises. I will just enumerate you a few promises that God has given us. John 8:36. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Hallelujah. Did it make a reality in our life? Romans 8:1-2. There is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit is life in Christ Jesus, and made me free from sin and death. Hallelujah. You know, before, when I'm not walking on the will of God, every time that I hear a message, I feel that, Lord, hindi ako sigurado sa aking kaligtasan, Panginoon. I'm not sure where I'm going. I felt condemned. I feel like I'm going straight to hell. But you know, those who walk after the Spirit, hallelujah. When I started walking in the Spirit of God, when I started walking in the Spirit, hallelujah, I am now confident that I am no longer condemned, but loved. I am no longer despised, but I am loved by the most powerful being in the universe. Psalms 34:7. The angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and deliver them. Hallelujah. You know, there's one requirement of God's protection to us. And that requirement is just fear the Lord. Isaiah 41:10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. So many promises. Isaiah 54:10. For the mountains shall depart and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall my covenant, shall the covenant of my peace be removed, saith the Lord that hath mercy on thee. The mountains shall depart, the hills be removed. All these things that we see, hallelujah, will disappear from our right before our eyes. But the kindness of God, hallelujah, and the covenant of peace, hallelujah, will not be removed from us. Psalms 103, verse 17, but the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon him that fear him and his and unto his children's children. Hallelujah. You know, when we fear the Lord God, the inheritance of that heritage that God is going to impart from our generation. The fear of the Lord, hallelujah, will be inherited by our children. And the mercy of the Lord, hallelujah, is going to be from everlasting to everlasting. One of the promises of the Lord that has been really become alive in the past few weeks of my life is this Psalms 23 verse 4. And sabi doon, yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. I was never so near to death than in the past few weeks of my life. I can smell death. I can see death. I can taste death. Maybe some of you know that my sister is battling with cancer. And when I speak to her, you know, andun na yung makikita mo na sa bingit na talaga siya ng kamatayan. You can taste death. You can actually feel death hovering nearby. But God says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, hallelujah, I will fear no evil, hallelujah. The good thing about God, about what God has given me is, I did not stagger. Even I see my sister, which is, pag nagsalita na, ikaw na lang magsalita, hindi na ako makapagsalita. Ganun na ang boses. And the doctor has even told her that she has only 3 months to live. But these words has become alive in my heart. These words has become alive in my life. The promises of God. The promises of God. You know, when God spoke his word, when God speaks his word, he has also faith that word is going to come to pass. Hindi lang tayo pag tayo nagsasalita, kailangan natin ng pananampalataya. Ang Panginoon din, mayroon din siyang pananampalataya sa kanyang salita. That when he sees these words, when he says these words to us, hallelujah, he knows that it is going to happen in our life. He has absolutely, he is believing absolutely that this is going to come to pass in our life. Hallelujah. Kaya sabi ng Panginoon, hallelujah, so shall my word that goeth out from my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every word that God has spoken to us, hallelujah, it will return to him with a praise. It will return to him glorifying his name, because it has accomplished a purpose. If you believe that God shall supply all 1:8, hallelujah. Ang sabi ng Panginoon, but ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and into the uttermost part of the earth. Hallelujah. God is going to make you a compelling witness. God is going to make you a powerful witness when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And I believe every one of you will, hallelujah, has received the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And you will come, hallelujah, you will stand in front of these people, demonstrating that the God that you serve is a powerful God. It's the same God who made miracles before. It's the same God who is going to make miracles today. And it's the same God that is going to make miracles in your future. Hallelujah. Our slogan in the church. Hallelujah. I don't know why I have imagined this word, but you know what? When we start believing it, when we started crying out loud, every member that comes to this church, hallelujah, is a miracle. Because every member, hallelujah, is a miracle. I will ask you one by one, and you will tell me, hallelujah, that God has wrought a miracle in your life. Hallelujah. Because it's the same God that has anointed the 12 disciples, the 40 followers of Jesus in the upper room. It's the same God, hallelujah, who has anointed us with His Holy Spirit. Number two. Word spoken by God's servant. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 14, neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy with the laying of the hands of the presbytery. Presbytery means a group of people who is declaring, who is saying the words to you. You know, kinaugalian ng church nito. That when the elders, when the servants of God are ministering, they always say a word. That there will be a word that will be spoken to you. I tell you, remember that, because you know God is will honor the word of His servant. If you start to believe the things that are spoken over you, hallelujah, it will come to pass. And sabi nga ni Paul kay Timothy, neglect not the gift. That means it's already there. Sabi niya, Timothy, nandiyan dyan na yung gift na binigay sa iyo. Through the word of prophecy, it was already given thee by the word of prophecy, hallelujah, by the laying of the hands. When God speak, hallelujah. I remember the prophecy that Beth has given to that young married couple in Saudi Arabia. Ang tanong sa kanya, do you believe that God? Because they have been that woman and that magtagal sila ng sasama. Now, because the woman is the only daughter and the boy is the only son, they are desperately longing for a son. Kaya lang baog silang dalawa para silang baog. And they have been living for 7, 6, 4 years They've been living for 4 years. They cannot make a baby. But when God speaks through His servant, hallelujah. Ang sabi sa kanya, ang word of prophecy sa kanya, tinanong naman siya, do you believe that God is going to give you a child? He said, yes, I believe. And then ang word na sinabi sa kanya, next year you're going to have a baby. Hindi namin nakita sa church after a couple of weeks, third week, bumalik. Tuwang-tuwa. Hindi alam na kanyang asawa na buntis siya. doon sinabi sa kanyang asawa na buntis siya. And the following year, she said, baby. Words that are spoken by the servant of God, hallelujah. Make a note of that. And when you start believing on them, I tell you, God is going to honor the word of His servant. God, word spoken by parents. Sometimes, you know, makikita natin yung ating mga anak na talagang, you know, it's not worth tama yung kita mo sa Lord, magsasayang mo na ako ng magandang salita sa batang ito kasi hindi nakikinig kahit hindi na magandang salita yung kanyang naririnig, hindi pa rin nakikinig. But you know, things we need to be aware, we need to understand that the things that we speak to our children, hallelujah, is being honored by God. When we speak curses, it will also come to pass in our life. One day, nung time na binata pa ako at saka during our younger days, merong mag-asawa, merong magpapakasal. Itong lalaking ito ay meron siyang siya yung pinaka-breadwinner ng pamilya. Now, matanda na siya, he's already going 40. Kaya gusto ng mag-asawa. Ngayon, may nakita siya na nagpusuan niya ng isang babae, pero hindi ito gusto ng kanyang nanay. Kasi siyempre, yung nanay gusto pa rin na... Tapos, nung inasal na, nasabi ng nanay, hindi din kayo magiging masaya. That's what the word that has been spoken to that couple. What happened is, in a couple of years' time, yung asawa ay nabuntis. Nagkaroon ng ectopic pregnancy. Hospital bills upon hospital bills. Hanggang sa ang kayamanan, ang lupa, ang bahay, nitong lalaki ay ubos, simot. That they continue living together. Nagkaroon sila ng tatlong anak. And then, at the last part of their marriage, hallelujah, silang dalawa ay naghiwalay. Hanggang ngayon, hiwalay silang mag-asawa. Because of the word that has been spoken by parents. If you want to set the course, if you want to set the course of the future, to set course the future of your children, hallelujah, speak the words of life. Hallelujah. I will just give you an example in Genesis 27:29. Ito po ay si Abraham. Ang sabi ni Abraham, o ang sabi ni Isaac, sa kay Jacob, verse 29, May nations be your servant, and may peoples bow down before you. May you rule over all your relatives, and may your mother's descendants bow down before you. May those who curse you be cursed, and may those who bless you be blessed. Hallelujah. Powerful, powerful word. So titingnan nyo, hey, kung titingnan nyo ang bansang Israel, napakaliit na bansa in the midst of the Arab nations, but still a powerful nation, but still a blessed nation, because of the words, of the powerful words that has been given by their parents to Israel or Jacob. That's the impact of the word that you are speaking to your children, parents. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 49. Ang sabi ni Jacob sa kanyang mga anak, Jacob called his sons and said, gather around and I will tell you what will happen to you in the future. Come together and listen, sons of Jacob. Listen to your father Israel. And sabi niya, Reuben, my firstborn, you are my strength and the first child of my manhood, the proudest and strongest of all my sons. You are like a raging flood. But you will not be the most important, for you sleep with my concubine and dishonor your father's bed. Simon and Levi are brothers. They use the weapons to commit violence. I will not join in their secret talks, nor will I take part in their meetings, for they killed men in anger and they crippled bulls for sport. A curse be on their anger because it is so fierce, and on their fury because it is so cruel. I will scatter them throughout the land of Israel. I will disperse them among its people. Judah, your brother will praise you. You hold your enemies by the neck. Your brothers will bow down before you. Judah is like a lion killing his victim and returning to his den, stretching out and lying down. No one dares disturb him. Judah will hold the royal scepter, and his descendants will always rule. Nations will bring him tribute and bow in obedience before them. Hallelujah. He ties his young donkey to a grapevine, to the very best of the vines. He washes his clothes in blood red wine. His eyes are bloodshot from drinking wine, still white from drinking milk. Hallelujah. Blessings that parents utter to their children. Hallelujah. The word that are spoken by parents. Our words can change the course of our future. And sabi sa Matthew chapter 12, verse 36 to 37, but I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. For by his words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. Hallelujah. Sometimes we don't realize, not unconsciously, we speak words that are not appropriate. No? Words that is not supposed to be spoken by children of God. And we need to be very careful of these words, because in the day of judgment, sabi ng Panginoon, si Jesus ang nagsabi nito eh. Sa Matthew chapter 12, verse 36 to 37, sabi ni Jesus, every idle word that you say to men, hallelujah, and you are saying to people, you will give account in the day of judgment. In James 3, 1 to 5, no one has stained the tongue. My brothers, Not many of you should become teachers. As you know, we teachers will be judged with greater strictness than others. All of us often make mistakes, but if a person never makes a mistake in what he says, he is perfect, and he's also able to control his own being. We put a bit into the mouth of a horse to make it obey us, and we are able to make it go where we want. Or think of a ship, big as it is, and driven by such strong winds, it can be steered by a very small rudder, and it goes wherever the pilot wants it to go. So it is the tongue, small as it is, it can boast about great things. Hallelujah. Our tongue, our lips, our word is going to set the course of our future, depending on what words comes out from it. Hallelujah. Lastly, the encouragement to us is what Jesus has said to us. In John chapter 6, verse 62, what gives life is God's Spirit. Man's power is of no use at all. The word that I have spoken to you bring life, God's life. Giving Spirit. Hallelujah. John chapter 6, verse 62. Hallelujah. The Spirit is the one who gives life. The flesh doesn't help at all. The words that I have spoken to you are spirit and our life. Let's be like Jesus. When you speak word, hallelujah, speak the word that will create life in our being. That will resurrect life in every dead part of a person's life. Hallelujah. God has given us a creative ability. Use it. Use the creative ability to speak the word of this, to set the course of your future. Hallelujah. It should be a word that is spoken, hallelujah, by faith. That will create power, create miracles in our life. In Jesus' name. Bye, boy, tonight.